Halftone 2 includes a number of settings that allow you to customize its behavior. To access the settings panel, tap the gear icon on the toolbar. First, we'd love it if you'd take a moment to review Halftone 2 in the App Store. To get to the review page in the App Store, tap Review in App Store. If you'd like to follow the latest news related to Halftone 2, tap Facebook Fan Page and make sure that you click the Like button on the page. The first of the customization options, you can turn snapping on so that elements on the page snap to edges. For example, if I turn snapping on and I drag this caption near the upper left corner, you'll notice that it will snap to the edges. Also, if I resize the caption, it will also snap to the edge. You can use the snapping feature to precisely place and position elements on the page. The enhanced picker option is used to control which image picker is used to select photos. When the enhanced picker is on, and you tap a panel to load a photo, you'll be able to use Halftone 2's advanced image picker to select images from your device, from Facebook, from Flickr, and from Instagram. When the enhanced picker is turned off, loading a photo in a panel will use the standard built-in iOS image picker. The radial menu help option controls whether or not help text surrounds the radial menu. This is very useful if you're learning how to use Halftone 2 for the first time. If I turn this option on, whenever I bring up a radial menu, you'll notice the help text that surrounds its perimeter. Radial menu help will remain turned on until you go into the settings menu and turn it off again. To control the size of images that are imported into Halftone 2 projects, tap Image Import Size. The default setting is medium, which is appropriate for most projects. However, if you'd like higher quality output, feel free to increase it to large or full. But note that larger images will require more storage, and they certainly will require more processing time. So it's best to choose a reasonable balance. To watch the short introduction that appeared when you first installed Halftone 2, tap the Guide menu item. From here, you can watch the overview of Halftone 2 that's included in the app. Click Next to move to the next topic, and finally, click Done to dismiss the guide. To find out more about the version of Halftone that you're running, tap About. The version number should be displayed along with the build number. If you're contacting Juicy Bits for support, it's helpful to include this information. You'll also find some acknowledgments with partners and products that we've used inside the app. If you'd like to reset your settings to the settings that were used when Halftone 2 was first installed, tap the Reset button and confirm that you'd like to reset your settings. The Reset option will not remove any of your documents or your favorites, so it's safe to use. And that's it. If you have any comments, questions, or suggestions, send email to info@juicybitsoftware.com or visit us on the web at www.juicybitsoftware.com. Thanks!